answer. He is the answer. And so we must pray for an outpouring of the Spirit of God in our day. The renowned Puritan Thomas Brooks of the 17th century said, after much praying, waiting, and weeping, God usually comes with his hands and his heart full of mercy to his people. He loves not to come empty-handed to those who have sat long with tearful eyes at mercy's door. Pray for an outpouring of the Spirit in our day. And then, when it seems that the wait is long, don't get discouraged. Don't give up hope. Be faithful. Because I want to tell you, God has written the final chapter. He will have the final word. The day is coming when heaven will be opened and we will see a rider coming upon a white horse. His name is Faithful and True. With justice he judges and makes war. His eyes are like blazing fire and on his head are many crowns. And he has a name written on him that no one knows but he himself. He is dressed in a robe dipped in blood and his name is the Word of God. The armies of heaven will follow him, riding on white horses and dressed in fine linen, white and clean. And out of his mouth comes a sharp sword with which to strike down the nations. He will rule them with an iron scepter. He treads the winepress of the fury of the wrath of God Almighty. And on his robe and on his thigh, he has this name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He is God's great, eternal I Am. Amen. The Lord reigns. And in that day, there will be no more darkness. There will be no more sin. There will be no more sorrow. There will be no more tears. There will be no more pain. Prayer will be turned to praise, and faith will be turned to sight. So, chosen women, wait on the Lord. Let fear be turned to faith. And as we wait, let us be awake, alert to our current situation, alert to the certain coming judgment of God, and let us wail. The time for uninterrupted rejoicing is coming, but it is not yet. Now we weep, we wail. Let merriment be turned to mourning. Let us warn others. Let us move from isolation to influence. And let us wait on the Lord, moving from fear to faith. Would you bow your hearts with me in prayer? Holy, holy, holy Father, great are you and greatly to be praised. And this day we worship you as the sovereign Lord and ruler of this universe. We lift our eyes up to you and we say, oh God, we desperately need you in this dark hour. Give us, oh God, I pray, eyes to see what you see and hearts that feel what you feel. May we grieve over what grieves your heart. Lord, I just pray that in these days, you will cause us to wake up. Some of us are sleeping behind the wheel, oblivious to the fact that the car we're in is careening toward judgment. Wake us up to the fact that we're in a burning house and that our task here on this earth as your chosen women is to warn others of the danger. Lord, there are women in this place today who need to be warned, who need to wake up to the situation in their own life, their own home. Give us, Lord, the compassion and fervor purity of heart, to care, to wail, to weep over the condition that we're in. Use us as women to influence others, and then cause us to wait with our eyes fixed on you. Not to live in fear, but to walk by faith. Oh God, we cry out to you. Have mercy on us this day. Heal, oh God, our hearts, our homes, our churches, and our land. For Jesus' sake, I pray it.